Okay, hello everyone. This is Vinny VDVG again. About a week ago I did this first part of the micro tutorial, which was about microing your herds, your villagers, your hero and basic stuff like that. Today I will do the second part of this micro tutorial, which is about microing your units. This means microing basic stuff, but also I will go into more detail about the advanced options you have in microing your armies. You can check out my YouTube and Twitch channels for the first part, and of course this part later as well. So first of all, I will talk a little bit about theory, and then I will go into some examples based on a micro scenario I did some time ago, and based on some real games so you can see how all this plays out in real battles. So let's start off with this, what micro is about. First of all, it is about using the right counter units on what they actually counter. So for example, you want to use skirmishers on musketeers and dragoons, and you want to use cavalry on skirmishers and stuff like that. Secondly, it is about taking out the biggest damage dealers. What I mean with that is, for example, you are, let's say, Dutch, you have skirmishers, and you have nothing else at the moment to defend those skirmishers. Now someone else is coming to you with some hussars and some reuters. Usually you want to try to target your skirmishers on the reuters, because they have bonus damage and that's the most effective trait for you. However, in this case you want to take out the hussars first, because they will do the most damage to your skirmishers. So you want to try, if it's only a few hussars, you want to try to snipe out those hussars, for example using your skirmishers, target all skirmishers on one hussar, use your town center, perhaps your hero, etc. Because they will deal more damage to your skirmishers than the reuter in the back. Third of all, it's about good positioning. Let's say you have ranged units, they are often weak against cavalry and rodeleros and melee units like that. So you want to try to fight in the defensive position, preferably near buildings so you can use them as a shield so the other melee units can't really get to you. On the other hand, if you have a lot of melee units like cavalry, you want to try to fight in a position that's best for you. In this case, that would be the more open fields. Fourth, it is about cost effectiveness. So let's say you have 5 hussars and your enemy has 8 pikemen. Now, of course, those 5 hussars can kill 8 pikemen if you micro decent. And you might be happy about that. But 5 hussars means you have invested about, exactly 1,000 resources. And 8 pikemen is 640 resources. So even though you might win the fight by killing all those pikemen, your 5 hussars will end up having very low HP. And that in fact means it's not worth it. Cost effect, so you have won the battle, you've won the fight, but you haven't won cost effectively. So in the end, if you do that multiple times, you will probably lose the game. As this great saying, you can win a battle, but it doesn't mean you win the war. Okay, fifthly, it is of course about how fast you are. Knowing the theory is one thing, doing it in practice turns out to be a lot harder. Depending on what your APM is, how many actions per minute, and how good you are multitasking, for example dealing with a raid, fixing your macro, your economy, and at the same time trying to micro at your main battle, it turns out to be quite rough. So of course you can train to be faster, but depending on how fast you are, you have to just skip a few things perhaps and focus on the most important things. Okay. Now let's go into some examples. First off, I have a micro scenario where I play for another guy. It's quite a few months ago. These are specific micro examples set up by someone who made the scenario. You won't often see them exactly the same in the game, but these are really great to show some to explain how you should micro different units against other units. And after this one I will go into real game examples and talk about how I micro there and what I do and why. Okay, so first off, this one. Um, Okay, so what do we have here is this is the micro scenario, by the way. If you want to download it, you just Google it, micro scenario plus Age of Empires or something like that, and it will probably turn up somewhere in the search results. We start here with 5 hussars. It's always equal, so if I have 5 hussars, he has the same. Now, how you want to engage this is as following. You want to move towards your opponent in a horizontal line. That's why you see me clicking right in front of these hussars all the time instead of over here. If I click over here, if the distance is too far, they will move in a vertical line. If I keep clicking right in front of them all the time, they will move in a horizontal line. The reason why you move in a horizontal line is that they will then have a better they will be in a better spot to attack the other units that will come towards them. They don't have to run around each other, they can immediately attack the closest one. Then next, as soon as you see other cavalry here, you will want to use attack move at first. That means that every unit of you is going to attack the closest one of his, of the one he sees. And then you want to start micro manually and adjust where needed. And basically you want to target the hussars of the other guy with the lowest HP. That's why you use the Alt key to see hit point bars. And likewise, you want to move your cavalry with low HP back so that it won't die right away, but you can still use it later again. Or even better, if you move one cavalry to the back, he might follow it with other hussars, and that means they are not damaging your cavalry because they are running after each other. This is an example you, for example, see in a lot of team games. You have two guys raiding, usually of both teams, and at some point they will meet each other on the map, and then it's about how you micro your cavalry to get the most out of it. Okay, that was how you're supposed to do it. Now let's see how this is going to play out. You see I'm clicking here, I keep moving towards him. Okay, then first I use attack move. Every hussar is attacking the closest one. That is just to get the first hits off in the best way I can, and to make sure that all my cavalry is immediately in the best position. After this, you will want to use all your cavalry to target one of his first, because as soon as you take one out, you will only have the damage of 4 hussars instead of 5. So that's what you see me doing here. I selected this whole group and attack this hussar over here. Meanwhile, you want to move your hussar with low HP back, and that is usually the front one. So you try to get him to chase your hussar while all your other hussars are still attacking this one. And that's what I'm going to do here. You see I'm moving it back. He's still moving behind it to get it. Then he realizes that he should not do it, so he gives them another command, and that is to attack this hussar. And that is actually the whole game here. Both of the teams are trying to move the low HP ones back, while at the same time trying to focus one of the other hussars or the most low HP hussars. Okay, there you see. Keep using your Alt key to see how the hit points are going over there. And then again, here I move one of them back, and okay, he realizes it's over. Then he just deleted the units. Okay, that was the first thing. Second one is going to be coming up any second. Okay, this is interesting. This is 15 hussars. It's the same thing, 15 versus 15 hussars. This will happen in later game stages when you all have more economy and more units. The basic idea is the same. You want to move in a horizontal line towards your opponent, and you want to use attack move as the first thing when you see the other units. What he is going to do here, that's actually a smart thing, is move in two groups. Let me just go to that point first. You see I still have one group here. Here, you see he comes with two groups. If you time this out right, that means that they will both attack at the same time. It's actually better than what I do here, because what will happen here is he will also use attack move, but for both groups. And that means that the first front hussars will of course all find their target, but he has only three and three here in the back, who will have to walk to the edges or to the middle to find their targets. I, on the other hand, have 2, 4, 6, 7 hussars in the back, who will all have to walk around to find their target to attack. So what he is doing here is better. The basics are the same. Attack move at first, and then manually adjust and find low HP ones of him to move to attack and pull your low HP ones back, as you see me doing here. And hopefully he chases them, then you give him a new target, etc. This is another interesting thing. Actually, I'm kind of losing this battle here, to be honest. But what you see here is that I have 2 hussars here, fighting with 2, 4 of his 5. That's never a good trade. You're outmatched, that's not what you want to do. Here, you see that I have more hussars attacking his group over here. That's a good trade for me. So what I'm doing here is I'm moving both of these hussars back. Meanwhile, of course, these still keep fighting, which is in my favor. So I will have a better trade of this. While I move these back, they are not doing as much damage to me. And then I will re-engage at this point when I have more hussars close and available to attack this group, which is about now. Then you see that all the time that he was chasing me, he had 4 hussars chasing 2 hussars. That means that he has 2 hussars less effectively in battle. And that's positioning that also helps you a lot here. Okay, round 3 is coming up. Okay, here we have 10 musketeers versus 10 musketeers. If you are in these kind of situations, you can... Okay, let's go a little bit into the detail. Depending on how much of a game fanatic you are, you can go into a lot of detail and just calculate everything and see how many shots you need to kill another unit. So I've made a quick example for that. Musketeer has 150 hit points and it has a 23 ranged attack. So let's go to here. What you can see here is if you divide the hit points by the attack that the musketeer deals, you see that it needs 6.52, which is rounded to 7 shots to kill one other musketeer. I did this calculation after the micro scenario, so if you do it correctly here, you will use 7 musketeers on one of his musketeers and use the other 3 musketeers on a new musketeer. If you do it like that, you will not waste fire and do the most optimal damage possible. What you see here is we will both start off with just using every musketeer to shoot one of the other musketeers. But if you want to do it the best way, you can make these calculations and at some point you just know how many units you need. What you see here later is now I realize that I have too many musketeers shooting one. So at some point I'm gonna split up here, for example. You see that... one of these had low HP. So I noticed that I, of course, don't need every musketeer to kill that one, so I made a new group and attacked another musketeer, while I will now use 1 or 2 musketeers to kill this last one and keep readjusting like that. Then another thing you can do is moving low HP ones back. Because he is probably trying to target your low HP units. You always want to take out low HP units first so that they can't do any more damage. And if you are exactly in the right range, musketeer has 12 range. So this is 12 range here. If you move it to the back, you might get him to chase you. And then that means he will not be shooting at you. And then the other units of you will do more damage. Okay, in the end it's 4 versus 3 musketeers, he realizes it's over, and then kills it. Here we have musketeer and hussars. Basically, this is of course something that will happen often in the real game. What you always want to do with these kind of units, first of all, use your range. Always, if you have ranged units, use your range and try to do as much damage as you can before engaging in a real fight. So you use your line of sight here and try to pick off any units that you can. Here we both shoot each other's musketeers. What I will probably do here, let's see. I will block these hussars with my hussars, while at the same time using my musketeers to shoot them. The thing is that the way this is positioned now, all these musketeers are in range of his hussars. While of course a musketeer has very good damage for his hussar in melee mode, as long as it's going like this, it's just about using your ranged damage as effectively as possible. I can of course move all these musketeers over here to kill these musketeers, but then I would waste time in walking as well. So what you would do in these kind of situations, use your range as effectively as possible while taking as less damage as possible from your opponent. So I will shoot this hussar, move back, shoot again, move back, etc. While moving back, I stay out of range from him as much as possible. And I will still, you see that also, I'm moving my hussars back, so his musketeers can't shoot my hussars as easily as I am shooting his hussars. Again, I come back a little bit close, then I move my hussars back. And now you see that I have one hussar and a lot of musketeers left. You don't want to let this hussar just go over here too close, because it's just one hussar, and that means it will die fast in melee mode for his musketeers. Here, of course, you see I try to split up a little bit, not try to target one musketeer with all my units. There are a few more examples here I want to show. This is another one, very interesting. Skirmisher or crossbowman and dragoon, often it's often what's happening in the real game, or skirmisher dragoon. Here I did another example for you guys about the calculations, so let's take a look into that first. Dragoon has 26 damage and 0.3 ranged resistance. A crossbowman has 16 damage, 2 times multiplier bonus versus dragoons, and it has 0.2 resistance. So you can do these calculations to see how much damage every unit is doing versus another units, and then of course find out how many shots you need with one unit to kill the other. So what you see here is that a dragoon does 18 damage versus another dragoon. Versus a crossbowman, it does 21 damage. A crossbowman does 22 damage versus a dragoon, and it does 13 damage versus another crossbowman. For example, this calculation, crossbowman attack is 16. Another crossman has 0.2 range resistance, so the real damage is 16 times 0.8. Same for the dragoon, 16 damage, multiplier of 2, times 0.7, because the dragoon has 0.3 range resistance. Okay, these are the damage it does. What you then see is that, for example, a dragoon needs 13 shots to kill another dragoon. It needs 5 shots to kill another crossbowman. Likewise, crossbowman needs 11 shots to kill a dragoon, and it needs 8 shots to kill another crossbowman. If you are fighting with pure crossbowman dragoon versus crossbowman dragoon, or let's say skirmisher dragoon versus cazador dragoon, stuff like that, then you want to use it like this. Your dragoon will deal the most damage to your crossbowman, which you can see over here. Your crossbowman deals the most damage to your dragoon. So if possible, you want to use your dragoons on crossbowmen, and you want to use your crossbowmen on dragoons at first. You have to keep in mind, of course, that in the real game, early on, dragoons are really expensive units, and it's often more important to kill anti-cavalry. And if that is your main goal, you want to use every unit you have to kill the anti-cavalry. You know the basic counter system. But suppose it's a long game, especially in one-on-ones, for example, French mirrors, you have skirmisher dragoon versus skirmisher dragoon. You want to target your skirmisher on dragoons, and if possible, you want to target your goons on the skirmishers. But that doesn't mean you want to do that whatever it takes, because you have to take into account the skirmishers, of course, have 20 range and dragoons have only 12 range without the upgrade. Okay, so let's see. First of all, as I said before, you want to use your range every time you can. That is now, I will just shoot the first unit I can. I want to target a goon, but the dragoons are in the back. So I will first target the crossbowman, because that's the most damage I can get at this second. I'm probably using too many crossbowmen here to shoot one unit. That's my bad. You can do another calculation. How many? Oh wait, I did it exactly. You can see that you needed 8 shots to kill another crossbowman. That means that I can't kill 2. If I would micro this perfectly, I can use 8 crossbowmen to shoot one, to shoot this one, and then use 7 crossbowmen to shoot the second one. Again, keep in mind what I said before about APM. This was a long time ago, and it also depends on how fast you are, if you can micro it optimally. Let's see how this plays out. You see I will target one crossbowman here. Then, at this point, you see that I see some goons coming forward. I will then use the crossbowman on the dragoon, as explained before. They will do the most damage. What you will see here is that this dragoon, you can barely see the bar left here, doesn't die with all my crossbowmen. Just a second. A crossbowman does 22 damage for his dragoon. Dragoon has 240 hit points, so you need 11 shots. Okay, I guess I haven't used every crossbowman here or somewhere out of range, probably these in back. But anyway, I saw that this dragoon was low HP. I like I said before, I'm not the dragoons do the most damage versus crossbowmen, but these are now way too far for me to engage with these dragoons. So I saw that I could still snipe off this dragoon because it has low HP because it was damaged by my crossbowmen. So I then targeted this dragoon with my other dragoons to take out that unit, and that means that we both lost a crossbowman, but he also lost a dragoon. So in the end, my total damage output at this point is higher than his. Then my dragoons go to the back again. You see that my other dragoon here has low HP, that is now dead. You are not going to chase them all the way to the back. At this point you see I have more units in battle here. He has too far, he moved too far to the back. Okay, second thing. You can use your dragoons in melee mode, because in melee mode they will do, I'm not sure exactly how much damage they will do, but they will do pretty good versus units like crossbowmen and skirmishers, because these units have range resistance, and that means that in melee mode they won't have range resistance, of course, because they will just receive the full damage that the dragoon does. I think it's about 18 or something. Another good thing is that this crossbowman, you need to micro it manually to still use its ranged attack, because if you don't, it will manually go in melee mode versus this dragoon that is attacking it in melee mode. And of course, as we all know, skirmishers in melee mode have a very low attack. However, I disagree with what he's doing now, because there are too many units on the map. Using dragoons in melee mode is only good when you have a lot of dragoons and a few skirmishers or crossbowmen. If you are outmatched, don't ever do it, because you will lose everything to someone who micros decently. What I will do here is make small groups of crossbowmen and move them back. And this means that I can just use my ranged attack and just the good damage of crossbowmen, and he is not killing much here. In the end, I have many more units left, so I will just win this battle here. Okay, next is Hussars and Skirmishers. What you will do here is again use your range. So whatever you can take out here is good. Now I take out half the HP of this Hussar. That's always a good thing, because Hussar is the biggest damage dealer here. So you want to take out the biggest damage dealer first. That is the Hussar, not the Skirmisher. So you want to use every unit you can to take out the Hussars first. Also, after I shot, I will immediately move back. so that I have more time to still shot it again and kill it before it will really come close to me to attack me. So I shoot again here and run back again, etc. Now that I saw that this Hoshpar was almost dead, I didn't target it with all my skirmishers in the third time, in the third shot round. I split up my skirmishers a little bit. Here you see again that I am targeting low HP Hussars first. And now you see that I killed this Hussar before he killed mine, and that means that I'm going to win this because I have more of the biggest damage dealers left. And then I'm making small groups of skirmishers to split up. I don't need every skirmisher here to kill one of his, so I'm making small groups to use my damage output most effectively. Okay, this is I think the last example of this scenario, and then I'm going to go into real game examples. Just a quick pause here. We have skirmisher and dragoons. This is the last calculation I will do now. You will see here that a dragoon, of course, again, still needs, does 18 damage, needs 13 shots to get another dragoon. But we have a skirmisher doing 25 damage versus a dragoon, 13 damage versus another skirmisher, and thus it needs 10 shots to kill a dragoon and 11 shots to kill another skirmisher. The basic thing here is the same. Dragoons do better versus skirmishers than versus other dragoons. They do more damage. And of course you want to use your skirmishers on the dragoons because they do most damage to them. More damage to a dragoon, 25 compared to 13 versus another skirmisher. Also again, you want to use your range, so you want to shoot any unit that you see first before really engaging in the fight. I will snipe off a skirmisher here, he will do the same. We keep our dragoons in the back, and now you see that I'm going to move my dragoons forward, because of course if these units are in the back they will not be as useful. And I will target my dragoons here on his skirmishers. Meanwhile, I will take out his dragoons with my skirmishers, because they do the most damage, as explained before. However, if he's gonna run to the back like he's doing now, I won't chase him, because then I'm gonna waste walking time and I waste fire output. Then I will just shoot the skirmishers until the dragoons come back. It's kind of the same here. His dragoons are also targeting my skirmishers, but you see here that the early advantage I had because of better micro there made me win this fight. And of course here I'm making small groups here of skirmishers to target this one, small group here to target this one. That is just to not waste fire again. Why first the skirmishers? Well, that is explained before with the calculation. So this one is one. Then next one. Okay, this is I think the last one. Again, skirmishers in front, 20 range, try to use any range and attack any unit possible. And afterward, okay, when there's going to be the real fight, skirmishers should target dragoons, that's the counter unit. Your dragoons should target hussars, cavalry, dragoons do very good versus them. You should try to keep the dragoons in the back actually, so they will live as long as possible. And your hussars, and this is interesting here, in my opinion, your hussars should first block his hussars and not take out the skirmishers. Of course, a hussar is a direct counter to a skirmisher, but in these kind of situations, I feel that the hussar does the most damage, and you want to take out his hussars first. That also means, actually, that I should use the skirmishers on the dragoons. If the dragoons are going to be too much in the back, I should use the skirmishers on the hussars and not on the other skirmishers. So let's see how this plays out. I will come in here to block his hussars. I will manually target my dragoons on his hussars. I will also use my skirmishers to kill the dragoons here, as you see. If they are too far, well, they're not too far, so I can keep killing them. And the other skirmishers are now targeting hussars here. What you see is that my better targeting here made me won this little skirmish, and I have more hussars here left. The skirmishers keep targeting the dragoon, and then it's just you see how much trouble these skirmishers have killing this one hussar while doing so much damage. Okay, let's see what comes up here. We had this one already. Oh wait, Skirmisher Dragoon. Okay, this is also okay. This is also, of course, something that happens a lot in real games. Again, skirmishers going up front, trying to snipe off anything they can. What you want to do here is the same thing. You want to use your hussars. Actually, you want to use every unit to take out the biggest damage dealer again. However, you have to keep in mind here that there are musketeers mixed in. Musketeers are counter to hussars, to cavalry, the hussars, Uhlan, stuff like that. So you want to use your musketeers on his hussars. Ranged or melee mode doesn't really matter. At first, they do really good damage in ranged as well, 23 per shot. So you want to take out the hussars first. If the hussars come really close, you can put some of your musks in melee mode, but in this case I prefer not to, because we are of course both microing really hard, and if you put some in melee mode, what he will just do is pull his hussars back. And that means that all the time they were in melee mode, they will not do anything, because that means hand attack mode, they will just go with their bayonet and walk towards a cavalry. And if you would have had them in ranged mode, you would do damage all the time, because they keep shooting, even if it's here or here or here, they shoot as long as it's in range. Okay, so how will this play out? My hussar is going back here, trying to lure him into me. Your skirmishers will target musketeers, because skirmishers are a counter to musketeers. They do bonus damage versus musketeers. Your hussars will take out the other hussars first, in my opinion, and your musketeers will also take out the hussars first here. Your musketeers should actually be more in front. My musketeers are in the back. I should move my skirmishers to the back and musketeers in front, so they will be a shield for me, for the cavalry. Also, what you can do here is use your musketeers to go really close to the cavalry, but like I said, I prefer to keep them in ranged mode. And if a cavalry is really, like, really close to a musketeer, this musketeer will automatically go into melee mode and thus do the hand attack damage and the bonus, etc. versus cavalry that it should. However, if the cavalry will move back, it will keep doing damage because you let it in ranged mode. So if the cavalry is not close, it will automatically change back to ranged mode. Only, in my opinion, if there is a really big battle going on with a lot of musketeers and a lot of cavalry, you can put, like, let's say half of your musketeers in melee mode, the front row, to do the most optimal damage versus cavalry. In most other situations, I think you should just stick to ranged mode and manually move them closer towards cavalry, so they will use their automatic switch when needed. You see here that I'm moving my skirmishers to the back while still trying to target musketeers here, and now my cavalry my musketeers are frontal shield versus this cavalry. I also moved my cavalry back. That's this positional thing. It was first here. There was too much too many enemy units. If I move it over here, I will have all these musketeers automatically killing this cavalry, so it will be a more cost-effective trade for me. As you see here, he puts the musketeers in melee mode. They will just run like clowns and bump into each other and just do not enough damage, and that's why you should not do it in this case. Meanwhile, you keep making sure that your skirmishers will do ranged attack. Of course, they suck in melee mode. Musketeers here are now doing the job they need to do. Also, one last thing. Skirmishers counter musketeers very well. They have bonus damage versus musketeers. But if a musketeer is in range, that means 12 range, he actually does pretty good for his skirmisher. He does 23 damage. So you want to take out musketeers as much as possible. And if you have, for example, a fight with musketeers versus skirmishers, let's say you're French, you aged up, you have skirmishers versus a British guy who has musketeers, you always want to use your range. So you shoot with or without attack move, depending on how much APM you got. You shoot, you move back, you shoot, you move back, etc. Try to keep out of range, because as soon as you get into range of musketeers, their 23 or even maybe 26 damage with upgrade does pretty decent, and your low HP skirmishers can still die. Okay, so this is now a one. I have one hussar left. Actually, it's still pretty close here. You see I'm making small groups here and not wasting fire. low HP here, so I will just use 2 to attack it, and the other 4 I'm gonna attack a new one. Same here. And okay, that's over. Then this is not really the practical example. Basically, I will just stop this micro scenario here. But basically, you want to target pikemen with your musketeers and crossbowmen. You want to use your musketeers to and your pikemen to block off the cavalry of him. Oh well, let's just see how it goes. Crossbowmen in front, try to pick off anything you can. My pikemen shoot now here. They're now going to move to block the hussars. Actually, he makes a mistake not pulling his hussars back. Meanwhile, my cavalry is going to the free side here because now he's only now moving his crossbowmen back. Meanwhile, your crossbowmen trying to keep them in ranged mode. Target pikemen. Target musketeers, of course, every anti-cavalry or the biggest damage dealer. That's the wait, it goes really fast. First, you're gonna target pikemen because they will do the most damage versus your hussars. Then you will want to target musketeers because musketeers with their normal range damage do very good as well. And if there's nothing left, then you're just gonna target crossbowmen. You see, I'm keep making smaller groups, and okay, this is over. So that was the micro scenario. Now I will go into some real game examples and talk you through the micro things going on there. And they will of course be about these things mentioned before: positioning, cost effectiveness, counter units, and taking out the biggest damage dealer, the unit that you want to take out first. It does it's the most annoying for you. Okay. 5.5. So what we have here is me playing French, and I'm making cavalry. And my mate here is Dutch, and he has some skirmishers and reiters. So what we see here is we are mainly fighting Aztecs with Mace Hill 10, that's like skirmisher thing, bow thing actually more, and pikemen. And their mates have cavalry as well, which are in the back here, coming up later. The pikemen counter the hussars, so I want to go to the Mace Sultans here to take them out, but I can't go to them because the pikemen block me. My job here is to make sure that I will lure these pikemen into our ranged army, because then the skirmishers, the musketeers I have and the reuters he has can take out the pikemen. Reuters of course are a direct counter to cavalry, but in this case they want to take out the pikemen because that's the biggest damage dealer versus me, and as soon as the pikemen are gone, I will be able to kill off these Mace Hill 10. Just a second. So what I will do here is lure the pikemen towards our army. You will see I move in, I move back again, his pikemen go back, means I go in again, meanwhile doing other stuff. I go in again, you'll see his pikemen coming back, so I will go back again. Actually I lose quite a few here. Then all our units can shoot the pikemen, and that's exactly the thing that's going on all the time here. Here you see, okay, this was actually, if you do this more often you will be better in anticipating this, because now I pulled off, I pulled back exactly the right moment when he changed around and moved his pikemen to the front. All these pikemen are in front, and you can see that it's quite easy for us to kill them. Of course, depending on how fast you are while doing your other things like economy, you can kill these 5 pikemen at the same time by making small groups of reuter, skirmisher, and targeting a different unit. Then I will go in again. He comes, I go back again. Meanwhile, killing more pikemen. I will go in again. And this is a back and forth game. What you see now, I wanted to take out the Mace Hill 10s here, because they, of course, do good versus the reuter. But he comes in with his cavalry, and I don't want to leave these skirmishers, which are worth more than Mace Hill 10s, uncovered. So what I will do here is, I see that his reuters don't have the best position. I will use my hussars towards here to block the hussars of him. That's okay because hussars versus hussars is quite an equal fight, but that allows my mate here to get into a better position with his reuter. And let's see, I will block them here. His reuter will go to this side, come closer as you see here, and then when his reuter are close enough, they can target the hussars, and I can go to, I can go downwards here and target more May Sultans. Effect here, still my hussars should be attacking his hussars when possible, not chasing them, but when possible, because they are the biggest damage dealers here, and the May Sultans don't do that much damage to my hussars. But when he just runs, I will just attack any unit that comes in my path here. Okay, next. 25, 20. Here I am French, defending versus Aztecs. He rushed me. Pretty standard pikes, May Sultan rush. In the start, of course, you don't have as many units as Aztec has, so you want to back off a little bit, defend a little bit, and you make sure you time it right. I target my town center here on the pikemen, of course, because they are the damage unit, the biggest damage unit, and I want to take it out first. Here, my hussars are coming in. You might wonder why they come in before my infantry. The idea is here is that I know that my army here will be able to take out his army if I micro correctly. So what I want to do here is make sure he can't run away. I will go in with my hussars, and only if all his pikemen, or most of them, are really going to attack my hussars, I will move them back. If not, I will attack and slow his units down, and then my infantry will come in the back and target these pikemen manually. You will see here, I come in. He's gonna attack me, so I'll move back. Meanwhile, my skirmisher and crossbowmen and musketeers can attack the pikemen. I will come in again, move back again, come in again, etc. And that's how you should micro these kind of things. Of course, you want to use control groups, and here it's just two control groups for me. One is the infantry, it's just mixed now in this case, musketeers and crossbowmen. And the second control group is my hussars. You keep moving to him. Now he only has two pikemen left, so I'm not gonna run from that because I have enough cavalry left. And you wanna keep moving here. Take out the hero, but keep moving. And take out the units of him. I know that I just took out quite a big big army of him, so I will move and push towards his warhut. What you see here is that he has coyotes made. This is like cavalry from the Aztec. I had three or four hussars there. I don't want to stay here because he has coyotes and even some skull knights. So what I'm going to do here is move back towards my infantry because I want to save my cavalry. Let my infantry shoot the biggest damage dealer. So that is a skull knight because he does extra bonus damage versus my cavalry. I want to take it out, and then when the skull knights were taken out, I will use my hussars again in battle and just fight the coyotes. It's just equal battle, and then of course target them to the May Sultans and take them out, and that's how you should micro this part. Okay, next one. 3057. By the way, as you see, I'm using all games I played previously, so if you want to recheck some examples here, you can just go to these videos and check it again for yourself. In this micro scenario, I explain a lot about like the theory and how you should engage these fights. But the reason why I'm gonna show you these real game examples is because often you play, for example, with a teammate, so things are a little bit different. Also, you have not exactly the same units and the same setups as in these micro scenarios, but the more real unit build order based unit combinations, and then things might be a little different, same as using like the houses and the buildings to your advantage and stuff like that. Okay, here in Russia, fighting with a mix of strelets and strelets and musketeers. We push here into the base of Artix, which is also Russian in this case. What you see here is I have two control groups. One is Strelitz and the second one is Musketeers. However you want to set up your control groups is totally up to you. I like this one because the one key is easy to use, and I will in this case use my ranged skirmishers the most. What you see here, that's actually also a micro detail, our skirmishers are just attacking this blockhouse, and meanwhile my Strelitz are shielding off his units. His Strelitz here, and Musketeers, of course want to try to pick off my Musketeers, so the cavalry, that's his mate, can kill them later. If you do it like, if you would have all your units, let's say here, it would be easier for him to pick off Musketeers. But now, my Strelitz are shielding his units. Strelitz have bad siege damage, so you always want to use them to kill villagers, units, even try to damage cavalry, anything possible, but preferably not sieging anything. If he really wants to attack my Musketeers, it means that he has to run over here and walk into my Strelitz and into all this fire, and that's of course something he doesn't want to do. So this was the positioning thing. Meanwhile, our Musketeers sieged it. I keep targeting units, of course Strelitz want to be used on Musketeers first, and if no other units in range, then just target Strelitz or whatever you can find. This is also what I talked about before, it depends on how your APM is, how much you can do at the same time. I also have to manage my economy. In this case, Blue was raiding me, so I have to get my villages back on time, all the time. All of this while microing your main army here. What you see here, again, Strelitz want to be targeting Musketeers first, so our cavalry, which is coming somewhere later, can kill the Strelitz easier. Again, we're going to do the same thing here, trying to shield off his units and let the Musketeers siege this blockhouse fast. Only if there's a real big fight, let's say that, for example, he has a lot of units from his mate here, then you want to use your Musketeers, of course, and really engage the fight 100%. But since this is not the case, Strelitz can just pick off units, Musketeers can siege this blockhouse, so he can't train units, and that's a good thing. What you will see here is that his cavalry, that's a lag thing. Okay, there you see his cavalry coming in. Actually, I hope that our Musketeers would get off one or two shots to kill this blockhouse, but that's not happening here. His cavalry comes in. I will move my Strelitz back because they would die too fast. I will move them back towards the Musketeers. What you see here is that I told you before, cavalry is a melee unit. That means you want to try to fight in the most open spots as possible. Engaging in these small positions here and here is never good for cavalry, because if you have like five cavalry, they don't all fit in here, so that will mean two of them are going to attack and the other will just walk around, and that means waste of time and waste of damage dealt. This is a good position for us. I will just move back here towards the Musketeers, and if cavalry is going to chase me, these Musketeers are going to deal with them. Another nice thing Eric is doing here is you see more cavalry is coming here. He is going to shoot the cavalry. Again, here you don't really want to use attack move here with the Musketeers. It's better to select small groups, but enough of them to kill off Ulan, and target one Ulan. Move back, target one Ulan, etc. Then you will take out more Ulans probably than using attack move here. And the many more you can take out in the front, the more these in the back are going to get a weird padding and just have less effective damage versus you. So what you see here is that he is going to shoot these Ulans. Here it might seem that he is going to get a good surface area, so Eric is going to move back to here, shoot again. You see that all this cavalry in the back has to now walk around here, and only these three in front could attack the Musketeers. So here he moved back towards here, shoot again, and then he can move back again, and then we have so many Musketeers that he knows he can't engage this, and he's going back. So this is actually very good micro from both of us with our Musketeers, taking as less damage as possible while dealing most damage as possible. And here the Strelitz are of course taking out Musketeers here whenever you can. Uh, 2240, there's something more I want to show, I guess. Okay, here you see that I'm moving back into this group here. My Stratas take out the Musketeers, his Musketeers and our Musketeers take out, oh yeah, the Udens. Okay, we in the end lost units still, of course. He also has his blockhouse shooting, more units pumping out and all the units in the back. Meanwhile, Death Star gathered more cavalry and came from this side. He had a much better angle here, no trees, no blockhouse blocking. So we have to go back. Right now, the best thing to do is leave this one musketeer behind and run with the rest, because you don't want to get caught by this cavalry while all this infantry in the back will shoot you. Another option is to just shoot, run back thing. So shoot this cavalry, run back, shoot this one, run back, shoot this one, etc. But you don't want to stay here because we are not we don't have enough. So we're now moving back. You see here, he shots one, moves back. We're gonna go to our defensive position here near our barracks, where we have units pumping out. He stays a little bit too long in my opinion, but still doing pretty decent. The thing is that as long as you keep doing this, move back while shooting discovery, you will always prevent him from getting the best surface area, EA, with every cavalry attacking one unit. All the time while we were walking back, you had a few cavalry in the back which just couldn't get to our units. And here we're just going to use cavalry. You see, we're not going to put it in melee mode, we're just going to move it close, and the units that are really close will just attack the cavalry in melee mode anyway. And that was the last thing of this one. Next one. 10 minutes 19. Okay, a 2v2 here. Let's see. What we have here is Ottoman French mirror. So we kind of both have the same. Sorry, we kind of both have the same unit compositions here: Abbas guns and Janissaries, and both have cavalry hussars. Now what you see here is we are going to engage this. So hussars, or sorry, Abbas guns are like skirmishers. Units that have a good range and do very good versus musketeers, so Janissaries. Also, I want to take out. Well, let's see. First of all, I want to shoot every unit that is in range first, because any unit you take out means less damage from him to your army. In this is a really special situation because Abbas guns are so OP that you, in this case, you want to take out the Abbas guns first, because they do so much damage to your Janissaries and your Abbas guns, that, and still decent damage versus cavalry, that you want to take these out first. Normally, if it's like Musketeer Skirmisher and Hussars versus Musketeer Skirmisher Hussar, you want to take out the Musketeers first with your Skirmishers. But now you want to take out the Abbas guns first, because they are such a strong unit. Only when there's a real fight going on here, that means when we both fully commit to it and the hussars of my mate here are close towards his units, then you want to take out the Janissaries, because in melee mode it will do very good damage versus hussars. So what you see here is how it's going to play out. I am not really engaging here, and that is because Darwin, very good player by the way, just small mistake here in my opinion, he is waiting on this side. What can happen here is very dangerous, because if he waits here and they will both engage on me at the same time, I will not be able to micro back all the way to here. If I micro back here, it's not good either, because his hussars have to walk around. If they 2v1 me here, it will mean that my Abbas guns are gonna die really fast, as well as my Janissaries, and then they will 2v1 him, and that's something you never want to have happen to you. Of course, you want to try to do that versus your enemy, but you don't want to have it happen to you. So what I say here is that he should come behind me. If he would have his hussars here and he would run up behind me, we can both push in towards this and he can block the other hussars, and that's my main point here. If he's not behind me, he can't block the hussars, and that means that everything will just engage me and fully surround me here on all these sides, and that's not good for me. So I'm kind of hesitating and waiting here until he comes behind me. Okay, they move back, and that means that we can merge our armies here. You see I'm making two groups here. You see Abbas Guns is first, trying to pick off any units you can, and Janissaries in the back, waiting to engage only when cavalry comes. That was the positioning thing, then 11, 10. So now the fight is really gonna emerge here. Abbas Guns in front. You see that I'm doing this very carefully. You don't wanna waste or commit too early because he might be running into you and you might be caught off guard. So why is nothing happening here? 11, 10. Go, go, go. Okay. Darwin is getting ready. So here, Abbas Guns in front. Try to see what you can kill. First, Abbas Guns. So attack the Abbas Guns there. Here you want to see, you see that my Janissaries is now going to move towards here to block the Hussars of him. And I can put them in melee mode if needed. While still my Abbas Guns are shooting his Abbas Guns. We kind of have a bad position here and some lag I see. I keep moving my Janissaries with his Hussars because the other Hussars will block him. So what you see now is here. It would be good to have a few, but not too many, because then I would block his Hussars. A few of these Janissaries in melee mode versus the Hussars. But what you also have to do is adapt to your position. I can't put them all in melee mode anyway, because they would just run into each other here and can't attack. So having them here in ranged is still fine, and just killing off the Hussars that are close or the Janissaries is the best thing to do. Also, I came from this position, and what you will do is move towards here, but not just move by one click and going here. You want to move here, shoot this Hussars that are moving towards here, move closer, shoot anything you can, move closer, and then micro more. Meanwhile, the Abbas Guns, these two are attacking the artillery foundry, that's not good of course. The Abbas Guns here are trying to pick off the frontal units that are doing the most damage to the cavalry of my mate. So they are now trying to pick off these Janissaries here, you see plus 13, that means that one is killed. They now should all be targeting these Janissaries. If these Janissaries here are not in melee mode, it's better to kill off these Hussars first, because they will do more damage. You see me manually targeting the Janissaries here, I'm kind of... These Abbas Guns are running around, it's not good. But in the end, I think he had one or two Hussars more as well, but we just microed better here and got the... Okay, here you see new Hussars popping out, you see I moved my Abbas Guns to the left so that my Janissaries can block off the Hussars. You see I put some in melee mode here, now it's a good thing to put them in melee mode, because they will block the Hussars so they can't attack my Abbas Guns. And they will just do good damage because they are all really close. And these Hussars were not able to really move back efficiently. While, for example, in the first part, if I would put my Janissaries in melee mode immediately, they would both just use their range, Abbas Guns as well as Janissaries, shoot me, move back, shoot me again, move back, and all the time my Janissaries did nothing. So never put them in melee mode too early, only if it's really useful, like in this case. Thirteen, ten. Yeah, we kind of winning this fight here. Keep targeting the Janissaries and then the Abbas Guns. The thing is, if the Janissaries are out, we can just, and we have more cavalry left, we can just catch the Abbas Guns. You can see how much micro makes a difference here, because we have so many more units left here compared to what he has, and it was just a mirror, so good micro and positioning of course matters a lot. Here I'm kind of getting trapped and caught here with my Abbas Guns being too forward, but it doesn't really, I'm moving them back towards my Janissaries, you know, for protection, but it doesn't really matter, we won anyway. Okay, next one. Oh wait. There's one more thing I needed to show there. When these fights first are happening, so when when you first engage but are still far away from each other, what both players often try to do is use attack move. That way you can just damage as many units as efficiently as possible and then manually later micro and kill off the low HP ones. Because if you have, like, let's say 20 Abyss guns or 30 skirmishers and you click them all to target one skirmisher, you're just killing them. You're killing the skirmisher, but you're wasting fire. If you see that a lot of these attack move situations are happening, also while there is just the real fight happening and not the shoot go back thing, but really two armies standing there and they're both attack moving still, what you can do, like a little trick, is move one of your units in front. Because if he uses attack move, it means that all his units will attack the unit that is closest to them. So if you use one unit and put him in front of all your other units, that means that one unit will be the closest unit for the enemy's army, and that will mean that even if he uses attack move, they will still all kill your unit, and that means they will still waste fire. That's often something you can use in fighting musketeer versus musketeer or something like that, because then it's really useful to do this little trick. Of course, keep in mind, if he's doing the same, then you want to manually correct it, so you don't want to have all your units attack moving this and killing this one unit, because then you are wasting fire. The next example is on 15.04. Okay, let's see. I am friends with the Hussars here. Oh yeah, this is about the biggest damage dealer again. You see up front, my mate here has skirmishers. Skirmishers are a valuable unit. Of course, they are more expensive than Maesaltins or Cosmomen. These units you can easily mess. So it's important to keep his skirmishers alive. Also because I need his skirmishers to kill off any anti-cavalry that they will bring. I have a lot of Maesaltins here that I can attack with my cavalry. Of course, cavalry counters Maesaltins. Normally, that's what you want to do. However, here his skirmishers are going to die to these Hussars, because it's most important for me to save his skirmishers, both needing to kill off anti-cavalry for me and because they cost a lot. I will use my Hussars here now to just kill off his Hussars first. The Hussar is the biggest damage dealer, you want to take it out. That's what I'm doing here. And like you see again, manually use the alt key and manually attack the lowest HP first. What you see here is that there were a lot of Maesaltins here. I don't really want to engage into that because he has 4 cavalry, I have 2 for 6. But if he targets the Maesaltin properly, he can do a lot of damage to my Hussar. So I will just move back a little bit. Just let these skirmishers use their range. Skirmishers have more range. If he micros correctly, he can target off low HP Hussars and move back. And that's what we're going to do here, hopefully. Yeah, exactly. He's going to move back, use range. I'm just staying there now to use my cavalry as a shield, nothing more. I'm only a shield for him at this point. Because I know that these 12 or 15 Maesaltins will do more damage than 5 skirmishers to my Hussars. Okay, now I have a decent army because I have 5 more musketeers on the way that will do good damage for his Hussars, and I just made a few more Hussars and my Cosmomen are on the way. That means we will be able to push in here. Of course, even while I'm pushing in, I take out the Hussars first because they will do the most damage to my Hussars. Before I will attack the Maesaltins here. The skirmishers you can... Here, okay, new Hussars are coming, so what I want to do here is again use my Hussars on his Hussars. The skirmishers and musketeers want to take out any pikemen or stuff like that, but if there are no pikemen coming, they will also both target Hussars. The Hussar is the biggest damage dealer, biggest damage dealer. So that's what you want to take out first. Also, your skirmishers should be used on this. I should use my musketeers here on these hussars, but okay, I'm gonna do that now, I guess. Again here, using your ranged mode is perfectly fine. If I would use melee mode, they will just run away. And even now, he is expecting me to use their melee mode. So you see that he's already moving his cavalry back. If I use melee mode, then I would just run after this one and not do any damage. While I have ranged mode, I will still do damage while he is coming here, running back, etc. I will still take off 2-3 shots. So we take out the hussars first. Low HP ones first, as you see me targeting there, and then when no hussars are left, you see that our hussars easily take out the Maesal tents here of the Aztecs guy, and then you just win the battle. It's a bit weird that the Aztec had not a little bit more anti-cavalry, or for example some pikemen or some coyotes. Coyotes are just cav of the Aztecs, and they can also block your cavalry. But anyway, that's how you should micro that most efficiently. A few more examples here. All should probably be different situations, so stay tuned here. I gathered these examples in the last days. It took me quite some time, so I hope you guys are enjoying it and learning a lot, because it will just show you how you should play it out in real games and most optimally and most efficiently micro your units. So this was a very long stream. 11.6.20. So what I'm doing here is I'm doing a French mirror. I'm playing the aggressive crossbowman pikeman style. Here again, like explained in this macro scenario, what you want to do is use your range. You don't want to waste your pikemen, you don't want to commit too heavily, you just want to use your range of these crossbowmen and take out, in this case, the biggest damage dealer, which is the hussar again, first. I shoot, I move back, I shoot again, move back, and only when I really need them, I will use my pikemen to engage this army. That's about now. But then I know that he will come in and shoot my pikemen, so I should use them a little bit, but quite soon move back again, as I'm doing here now, so to not waste your pikemen. And that's just a little micro thing going on here. And then I come in again, I just go in again with all my crossbowmen, see if I can do more damage, because I know I have the mass ranged unit. He has not as many musketeers and crossbowmen as I have. You see it's gonna get a little bit of a dire situation for him, so he's gonna use his villages to fight. You see here I'm again trying to pick off any unit that I can. So this is going on for a little bit. I move in, move my pike to the back, move in again. Just make sure you don't overcommit that, for example, some hussars are coming from here and gonna trap you, and then a Minutemen pop out and whatever his army has. So here all the time, just using your range. You have range, superior range versus musketeers. Good mass here, so you can do a lot. Here is Minutemen come out. I don't want to engage that yet. I don't want to waste my pikemen because it's only a few hussars, so I will just keep microing back. But you see here, he put his hero in melee mode. That's a very nice trick. Your hero, many people don't use your hero in battle. You shoot, you always shoot. So many people just have him on the map somewhere, and having him idle doesn't help you anything. A hero is 500 HP, or maybe less if you lost some, but still a lot of HP. It has 0.1 resistance of ranged damage, so it's a very good meat shield, a very good unit that can tank a lot of damage, especially of these ranged units like crossbowmen and musketeers. And what he did now is put his hero in melee mode. And his idea there was to slow me down, because any unit that attacks you, not ranged but in melee mode, will always slow you down. I will come to that later with some examples of how to micro versus that. But if he is slowing down my crossbowman mass, it will mean that his mess of Minutemen and Villagers and Musketeers, which he does have quite a good mess of now, can do more damage. So if he can slow me down with his Hussars and his hero, he can do more damage versus me. And of course you want to prevent that, so you will shoot the hero and move back. You see that I will switch this between using attack move and manually move, manually micro. First the Hussars and manually microed because I wanted to take them out one by one as fast as possible. And versus this kind of armies, I will often just manually, use attack move to make sure my damage is spread amongst the units. And that means I don't waste fire by killing, by targeting one unit, but I will deal as much damage to several units as possible. What you see here, he doesn't have a lot of Hussars left. I know that all his villagers are here, or a lot of villagers, so that means not many more Hussars are coming at this point, and I still have a lot of pikemen. So what can you do here? You are getting outmatched by a lot of ranged units. Coureur de Bois, the French villager, is also counted as a ranged unit here. So what you will do here is use your pikemen in cover mode. It's somewhere about here, you can see it now because I have selected the villager, but let's see. Okay, anyway, it's one of these, but not these you can see now, but one of these buttons here. It's called cover mode. What will happen is that your pikemen will move into this cover mode and walk slower. But the big advantage is that they will absorb a lot of more ranged damage than they would normally. And this way I'm just using them as a meat shield for me to tank as much damage as possible, so that my biggest damage dealer, the crossbowman, stays alive as long as possible. Here I'm gonna make small groups, micro them back versus the villagers, because you don't want to have your crossbowmen doing melee damage. You always want to have them do range damage, because that's what they do best. And keep microing back. Use your units as efficient as possible. I still use the Alt key sometimes here to use one or two crossbowmen to target the low HP units of him. Again, depending on how fast you are, you can really micro your ass out here, and your ass off, I should say, and do it the most efficient. I'm still fighting here, by the way, even though I'm a little bit outmatched, and that the reason is because as long as I keep fighting here, he has used a lot of villagers, and he keeps losing villagers and keeps losing mining time, gathering time. So all the time I'm still gathering and have economy and can make new units, so this is still a decent trade for me, even though I was a little bit outmatched. What you see here is there's a new change here, because Yemi had some new Hussars. Then you don't want to target the crossbowman anymore, you want to take out the Hussar first, because he will do the most damage to my crossbowman. And when you have taken out his Hussars, you will use your Hussars again to target his crossbowman, not the musketeer, of course. Meanwhile, your crossbowman will then take out the musketeers, because the musketeer will do the most damage versus your Hussars. So here I'm trying to go over here and attack the crossbowman, but because he has more than me, I will have to go back and block these Hussars, take them out first, before I could really engage this again. So that is what I'm going to do here. I'm going to move back and block him. Also, my crossbowman will be targeting these Hussars here, while of course moving back. As long as you keep moving back a lot, you will get an advantage in dealing in optimizing your damage versus him, because he will not be able to keep hitting you continuously, but he will have to move around and move towards you, attack you, move towards you, attack you, etc. Okay, I used some villagers just to get some extra tanking, extra damage out, and tank some damage from the crossbowmen, because I wasn't sure if it was going well. But anyway, I won that fight, so I can send my villagers back again. And what you see here is the last thing. It's now Crossbowman versus Crossbowman. That means you want to use your range as efficient as possible, combined with using your Alt key to see what hit points his Crossbowman have. And then I'm just gonna try to snipe off any Crossbowman I can. Snipe off one, move back, snipe off one, move back, etc. Because he wants to get down my Rex, but of course it's gonna take years with only Crossbowman. So any damage you can do here is always good. That's another thing I see a lot of people not doing efficiently in, especially team games, because I play a lot of team games. If they are sieging your Rex, use your units as long as you can. Now here, I know that he won't have any cavalry, so I can do this just freely without compromising my Crossbowman. But in team games, you often have, for example, some guy waiting here with musketeers or pikemen or whatever. So the guy that has range, I see Far doing that very nicely with when he's playing Dutch. The guy that has ranged units should always try to pick off units. Go in front, attack the units, use your range, and go back when needed. Because then your mate or yourself can have musketeers or pikemen waiting in the back to block any cavalry if really needed. But all the time you can pick off units is good. You just deal damage while he is not dealing damage to your units. That's what you see me doing here all the time, going back and forth. But never commit, never stay here, never go in too close that his cavalry can catch you. By the way, in the end I saw that he had new Hussars. But the reason why I still kept going in and picking off units is because I knew that I had Hussars on the way. So even if he would come with his Hussars, I could still move back towards my stable and use my Hussars as anti-cavalry versus him. Okay, then that's that. Next, cannon micro. Small example. 12. This is a stream where I commentated some of the games of the PK Clan tournament. What you see here is Ottoman versus Spain. Doesn't really matter. But what matters is that both have cannons. So what you will see here. Shimra has already put his cannons in the active mode, the shooting mode, and Guardia has not yet. He will do in any minute, any second. What is very important here is that you will know the range that your cannons have, so you can, so that you know at what point you have to be to attack his cannons. And the reason why they both put their cannons in active mode is of course because then they can shoot anything the moment they want and not still having to go through that animation. So you will see that they both will try to move closer towards each other with the cannons and getting the best angle and trying to pick off the other cannons. So this is really, really tense micro thing, because the one that that loses the cannons will probably lose the game at this point. So they will both just now move slowly forward. That means clicking here, right in front of the cannons, and never clicking here, because then they will do this animation thing and pack up again. What makes it a little bit complicated here is that Shimras is also having some Abyss guns here, and they can of course do pretty well versus cannons. So he never wants to have his cannons too far out front. So he will do any damage possible, because he knows that the other cannons were still out of range. Then it's okay to waste your shot, so to say, and take out some HP here. However, he knows that his cannons have to reload. If he would stay there, the other cannons would kill off his cannons. So what he's doing now is he shot and immediately he moved back, having some time to reload before going in again to his cannons. He was trying to come back and take out the other cannons. But now that his lancer came in, he has to go back and use his units to block off the lancer so his cannons won't die. That's this back and forth thing going on. Now you see that Garya is moving back again. not sure to really commit here. He can take off some free shots for the skirmishers, always good. He knows he has to reload, so he can't stay here because then the cannons would take out his. So he will go back again. Gaia is now gonna try to push in, and here you see that you should know the range. This is the exact range that you can take out the other cannons. This is the 26 range cannons have. You see that the first shot is coming from Shimras, that took out this cannon, and now they will just manually micro the other cannons and take out. Because Shimras had the first shots, he will win this battle and has one cannon left with half HP because he shot one first. So he wins this. It's very tense microing this kind of thing, but it's very important to really do it properly because it can really change a game, win or lose it. I will go into another 1v1 I played. I think it was a pretty fun 1v1 if you want to check it out later. I'm playing Russia here, and what you see here is that I'm gonna get trapped, almost. I was fighting over here, and I saw that he was calling his Minutemen, and I saw that some Uhlans cavalry were coming from this side. I don't have enough units here to fight this, and you never really want to fight Minutemen when they just pop out, because they do really good. You want to wait out until they have low HP. So what will you do here? You will, of course, run back. What most people do here is just run back without microing. What will happen then is that he will micro his Uhlan, and by microing his Uhlan, I mean that he will target this Uhlan on this musketeer, this Uhlan on this musketeer, this Uhlan on this one, etc. Doing that, he will slow down all your units while his Minutemen in the back can take them out, and of course the Uhlan themselves are dealing damage as well. I know he's a good player, so I know he will probably do that. That means that I will have to find a way to still escape with as many units as possible. I know that I'm not going to escape with all units. So what I'm doing here, what I'm going to do here is I select two musketeers and I will move them towards here to attack the Uhlans. What that will do is save me time, because it will slow down his Uhlans attacking me and they will have to take out these units. That's what you see here. By doing that, the other musketeers can run. And now I save them almost. Here I still think that I'm not going to save everything of them, every one of them, so I'm giving him another free musketeer to slow him down and make sure I can run with the other musketeers. Now that I have I've gone to my blockhouse here, I'm safe. And you see that I saved four musketeers there. If I wouldn't do what I did, I would probably lose all of them, maybe two left, but I think I just would have lost all of them. So if you are in a situation like that, when you kind of get caught a bit off guard, give them some units, preferably one or two, you know, not too much. Depends on how many units he has, of course. The more units he has, the more units you have to give. That will delay him, and you will be able to escape with the other units you have. Okay, what I'm doing here. Again, I'm gonna get a little bit off guard here. I should have known that he was gonna ship his crossbowmen about now, but anyway, my cavalry was here searching for units. So you see that I have musketeers here for his crossbowmen. That is never a fight you want to take. Crossbowmen counter musketeers, especially weak Russian musketeers, so this is not good. I can't escape here. I have 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 musketeers. If I escape, the crossbowmen will kill 2, 3 musketeers already. The Uhlans will slow down these musketeers while the crossbowmen kill the others. So this is split second decision making you have to do. You can't escape here. You even can't escape with the thing that I did before by catching some, because there are too many ranged units with a good counter and killing them too fast. So you have to fight. You have to make the best of it. And how do you make the best of it? Crossbowmen are weak versus melee units, because they want to be ranged. So I quickly put all my musketeers in melee mode. If I do that, they will do good damage versus the Uhlans, and they will prevent the crossbowmen to do optimal damage versus musketeers. And in fact, a musketeer will own a crossbowman in melee mode, because a musketeer has better hand attack and melee resistance, and the crossbowman has range resistance. So I put them in melee mode here. Usually you can say you want to get your cavalry back, you know, to the crossbowmen to kill them off and block the other cavalry. But here I can't move them back because he is already coming over here to block me. So I will just have to fight this cavalry here versus his cavalry and make the best out of this situation here. Of course, I put them in melee mode, but you see that they're all gonna be clumped up a little bit, and some in the back are not doing anything useful. Two options. One, have the ones in the back switch the ones in the back back to ranged mode. That's this one. And while the one in the front are attacking the crossbowmen and slowing them down, the ones in the back can still do good damage in ranged mode. Other option, manually micro your units that are in melee mode around them and give them all a specific target, so they all will go to that target. And that's what I'm doing here. I use small groups and move towards the crossbowmen, so they all will have better targets. So what you see here is that I killed this cavalry over here, and I did very good with the musketeers versus the crossbowman. He has to micro a lot to kill it. And now I have my cavalry left. So I will try to save as many musketeers as I can, move them back to normal mode so they walk faster, move them back, and let the cavalry take out the crossbowman, as will happen here. I still save 3 musketeers, or 2.5. And now my cavalry can kill the crossbowman. Okay, he has new Udans coming out, so I quickly change these musketeers to melee mode, because I know that there will be a fight, they can't escape, and in melee mode they will do better versus Ulan, so in this case melee mode is a good option again. Okay, what I see a lot of people do is when you get raided you put your musketeers in melee mode. I don't think that's a good option, because a good player will not just walk into you. They will walk into you to walk at the spot to see if there are villagers he can raid. If he sees a lot of musketeers, he will just back off and come again later. So if you have your musketeers in melee mode, you will probably not do any damage. However, if you have your musketeers in ranged mode, you can probably take off 1 or 2 shots and thus, in total, do more damage. So, in my opinion, if there's a raid coming, just use your musketeers in ranged mode and shoot his cavalry. Only when there's a real battle, for example when there's a lot of cavalry raiding and you really wanna you know for sure that there's really gonna be a battle, that he's gonna stay there, then you're gonna put your musketeer in melee mode, like the example before here near his town center, because you know there's gonna be a sure fight, and if there's gonna be a sure fight, your musketeers in melee mode will do better. Otherwise, just stick to ranged. And of course, here you shoot. Immediately see me clicking here, because you shoot, you move closer, you shoot again, closer, etc. You will, of course, do more damage in total than if you're just going to shoot here and let them stand here, because then the units will be out of range. But if you shoot, run closer, shoot again, you will do more damage in total. Okay, here I'm gonna have musketeers versus Doppelsoldner. Doppelsoldner are units that are melee units, and they have a ranged area. They have area damage. That means that they are very good versus units that are clumped up together. So what you wanna do is to make sure your units are not clumped up together, but are spread out. Because if they are spread out, they will take less damage than if they are all clumped up together, because of the area damage Doppelsoldner have. So what you see here is I will move back. Always, of course, Doppelsoldner have melee resistance because it's a melee unit, like a pikeman. It will be better for you to do ranged damage versus Doppelsoldner, also because your melee damage just sucks. And of course you want to avoid doing getting trapped by these Doppelsoldner, because they do so much area. So what you see here is that I'm gonna target them ranged with ranged damage, and immediately I move back. But also I will split up my units, because I don't want to get caught by Doppelsoldner when I'm all together. So I will move back here, shoot Doppelsoldner, move these to the left, these to the right, these to the top, and keep targeting them. I will lose my musketeers here anyway, I know that, but you just want to make the best out of it possible. So I will split up like that versus Doppelsoldner. You can do the same thing versus Cuirassiers, for example, and make sure that you have units shooting from every side. Put some in melee mode that are close, but let the other ones all be far away so they are not affected by the area damage of a cuirassier. Here I'm getting attacked by his Uhlans near my blockhouse. Just a small thing here. Blockhouses and towers have bonus damage versus cavalry. So in any case, you always want to attack cavalry with it. Especially of course if that's the biggest damage dealer that is most most hurtful to you and you want to take it out. But in most cases, it's always what you want to do. And that's what you see here. What you will see here is that I will use my Alt key again. Find low HP Uhlans, there one is dying. And click my blockhouse on that one to target it, so I do the most damage possible there. Here my villagers, yeah, they're just walking away. If they can tank some damage, it's okay, because I had a lot of villagers here. Because my villagers can tank some damage and die, that's okay for me in this case. Because my Cossacks do more damage than the villagers, so if my villagers stay alive longer... my Cossacks stay alive longer because he is targeting villagers. It means my total damage output will be more and thus more effective for me at that point. Here there's it goes really fast. I was moving my cavalry back, but I see that I get caught here. In a little bit I will explain another example of how you can escape, but in this case I just know I can't escape. I can try to run back, but he will just catch me anyway. In these situations, make the best out of it. Just attack one of his units with all your units, because then you will do the most damage to that unit. And just let them die, but fight, so you can do the most damage possible without just running away and dying anyway. And here is an example of microing your cavalry. What you see here is he trapped my cavalry, he has more, so I want to run. What you see here, this one is attacking this last Cossack. A good cavalry player, what he's doing now, will move his other cavalry manually around, because this one is already slowing down this whole group because he's attacking it. He knows that if I'm a good player, I will let this one behind, because if I let this one behind to fight this cavalry, this Uhlan, I can run with the other ones, because as soon as I let this one behind, it means that this group is not going to be slowed down anymore. He, in anticipation on to that, he already tries to move the other cavalry around here, because what you should do, as if you are him, this one should attack this one should attack this one, this Uhlan should attack this one, and this one should attack this one. That means you will slow down every unit of me, that means I just can't escape. But what you see here is that I think I was on time. I let this one behind, just let it die, so the other ones can run and the other ones can escape. And there you see on the minimap they are moving away and he can now never catch them. So if you get in a position like that, leave one cavalry behind if you know you're going to lose for sure, so you can save your other cavalry. If you don't leave it behind, you will get slowed down with your whole group, and probably lose more than one cavalry, more than one Cossack. And if he's a good player, he will manually target down more specific Cossacks of you, and that will mean that you will also lose them, so you can't escape anymore. By the way, I'll come to that later. next example, it's going to be about some Russia play, if I remember correctly. Come on. What's going on here? Okay. I am Russia. Currently, this is 3-on-3, 3 versus 3, but actually, it's kind of a 2v2 here. I am playing with Shimras here versus Darwin and Kumruk. They are Russia Aztec. We are German Russia. Aztec, of course, has a stronger push than German in the start, so we just want to defend a little bit. Here you will see some examples of micro on the right counter units, but also positioning. First off, he will use his town center to kill the biggest damage dealer, which is in this case the pikeman of the Aztec or the musketeer. Because as soon as they are dead, his Uhlans can do good damage versus the Maisel-Tin and Strelitz. What I will do here is, because I know that I can't engage this at the moment, I will just move back. You see me doing that here. I will move back. I should not engage this yet. So I will move back towards the left here and try to wait for some more army, more units for me, and get a better position. I'm also waiting for his Uhlan to return. You see on the minimap here he's raiding here, and some new Uhlan popped out from his stable, so I have to wait and get a good position. Meanwhile, I won't return to position here or in the back to his town center here or to the bottom here. Why? Because I know that my new reinforcements come from this angle, so I will always want to be able to join up with my new reinforcements. If I move towards the bottom here of this map, so more towards down here, they will be able to stand in between my reinforcements and me, and that's never a good thing, because then they can kind of cut off one of the two armies, and you don't want to have that happening. I keep my musketeers here in the back because I know that I need more strelets and I know that more units are coming, but I can still use the range of my strelets to kill off the musketeers here. So that's what I'm doing here. I regroup my strelets, I click on this musketeer, kill it, move back again. I click on the other musketeer, move back again. And now also communication is very important, but that's not the topic here. When I say, "Are you ready?" I'm gonna tell him, "Let's go." And this is when he should engage as well. Meanwhile, I keep targeting the musketeers and pikemen with all my units, because even my musketeers want to take out the anti-cavalry first, because that means that his cavalry can do the most damage. So you see me here attacking the musketeers. Okay, wait, another thing. Musketeers, no, strelets have bonus damage versus units like musketeers and pikemen, heavy infantry. So you want to target strelets, of course, on those units. Musketeers, however, should now be used to target the unit that is most annoying. The musketeers or pikemen, so his Uhlan can do damage. But what you saw there is that the Aztec guy used his hero to slow down our units. What you will do then is then use the musketeers to kill the hero, because you don't want to get slowed down. But the strelets do such a good job killing musketeers and pikemen that you want to keep targeting them, but your musketeers have a very good base damage and they are just very good to use on the hero of Aztecs here and take it out first. Same like your musketeers are very good to kill cavalry. If you have a good group of them, good number of them, you can just kill the cavalry one by one. Here you see that we keep following them because we know that we are in good position. I keep making small boxes here, small groups, to manually select and kill off the musketeers there and the pikemen. First off, the pikemen, because pikemen do most damage, and when there are no pikemen left, or when there are musketeers in range and the pikemen are in the back, you, as I told before, don't want to waste time, and then you will just kill the musketeers like I'm doing here at this point. Here you see also he's going to move them in melee mode, but before they really do any damage they are going to die anyway. These in melee mode, however, are a good option because they are directly engaging cavalry, and it seems that he is not microing his cavalry back. Probably he's busy or somewhere else. Then it's good to use them in melee mode, and the other units can just escape. But as soon as he is microing them back, you should change them back to normal mode again. Here you see that I'm gonna use my units on the musketeers, and that's pretty much it. You see that we are not gonna engage here because there are new units coming. We also know that there's a Russian blockhouse, an Aztec warhead, new units popping out. You don't want to trap yourself. They have a very good army of ranged stuff here, so I still have a lot of musketeers, which of course do not good versus Strides and Maisel 10 because they counter my musketeers. I only have a few cavalry left, so at this point we should just kill off the coyotes here and then move back, probably. Until we have some more units, mainly cavalry, Uhlans and stuff, and we can really engage in this. The blockhouses will do too much damage, so as I'm saying, now we will go back. And yeah, like I did in the first seconds here, you try to lure them towards a position that's good for you and where you want to fight, where he can pop out Minutemen, where he get trapped behind the town center, where he can surround his army well with Uhlans. So while luring them back, you want to use your ranged units, the Strelets with a good range, to pick off any units you can, preferably musketeers or pikemen. But even if you can't pick off them because they keep them in the back and micro correctly, still you can still pick off any Strelets or whatever that's a little bit out of front of the rest of the army. And any unit you can pick off is good while you get ready for the real fight. Another example here of how you should micro your cavalry. Okay, let's see. I am French here again, and my mate's British. I don't want to engage here. Why? Because... wait, let's go first. First off, I don't want to engage there because there were only musketeers, and the musketeers do very good if there are like 10 of them on my hussars. They have very good range damage. With 10 of them, they can damage my hussars a lot, so you don't want to go into this. Also, there's no reason going into this because if you got close to them, they do even better versus your cavalry, so you just want to move back. So I moved back towards here. However, he had his Cossacks a little bit too much up front. And if I can take out these Cossacks here, that's always good. So I will take out these Cossacks, or try to take out these Cossacks here, with my hussars. However, if he's going to move back all the way like he's doing now, I will also move back again. You see me already clicking over here, because I don't want to engage this yet, because there are too many musketeers which can shoot my hussars. So all I'm trying to do is scare him away, let him move back, and try to take out any Cossacks I can. Because as soon as I take out Cossacks, this allows my mate, of course, to make more longbowmen, and of course the Cossacks can't raid, etc. So if you can take out Cossacks or some HP, do it, but don't really fully commit here, because you won't have enough to really fight this off at this point. So here you see I'm moving back again. Then I'm gonna move in again, trying to take out his hussars, but when the hussars are gone, I move back again because there were a lot of musketeers, and they you should not engage that yet. Meanwhile, I give him time to shoot the musketeers, so I can then come in again later and shoot the Strelets. And that's the of course the basic micro going on. You go in back and forth, try to find a good spot and attack, but don't attack the units that counter you, in this case the musketeers, or don't attack versus too big of a mass of Strelets and musketeers, so you will lose your HP. And here now I will... Oh wait... So I will come back again here. If the musketeers move back, you come back again. that try to attack these strelets. So his musketeers can take out your anti-cavalry, the musketeers here, and you can kill the strelets or the Cossacks. And if the musketeers come up front, you move back a little bit. And in this case, kill the Cossacks first, because they would do more damage to your hussars than the strelets. And that's how you can you keep going back and forth with your cavalry. Okay, the last example of cavalry here. They are coming in again for a fight. Of course, he says he's ready. So what you will do here, we have infantry here and I have some crossbowmen here. They will of course target down the musketeers because that's the counter unit. Longbowmen and crossbowmen counter musketeers. Musketeers counter cavalry, so you want to take out these first. Any musketeers he has should be used to kill the musketeers as well, because there's no cavalry from them. So take out the biggest damage dealer of them, which is the musketeers in this case versus my hussars. And my hussars are going around the back to kill off these strelets, because these strelets do good damage versus his musketeers. What you see here is I will come around, like I do now. And then, I'm first moving closer. This is the same horizontal line thing I explained before. And when I'm really close, like now, no, wait a second, like now, now actually, then I will use attack move, so that every cavalry will just attack another different unit that they will see at that point. And then I'm manually microing more cavalry, so I will give these a different target, give these a different target, etc. Meanwhile, our infantry is attacking their musketeers. I have to say they don't do a really good job here, because the musketeers should move with the strelets back. Heroes is doing a good job here, because he's moving back, because he sees he can't engage this. Quentin Blunt should also move back and protect the strelets. First off, he should move back and use ranged damage, ranged mode. But if my cavalry is really committing, like it's actually doing here now, then he should switch some of these musketeers to melee mode, because they will do more damage. What I will probably do then is of course move my cavalry back again. And that's the point where you don't want to use melee mode again, but just ranged. Because every time you're going to use melee mode, I will just move those few cavalry back, while all the other units are shooting your musketeers. And then I will come in again and go back again and come in again. While if you have had your ranged mode on all the time, you will still do damage while you can move back. So you will shoot my cavalry, run back again, shoot again, etc. And if there is still really a fight, the frontal musketeers that are really in front of your army and are close to cavalry, they will still do melee damage to my cavalry automatically. Here you see that I'm taking out the Cossacks first, because they of course hurt my cavalry. And then I will use these hussars over here to manually go to the back while these attack from the front. So I will block his retreat path, and I will also make sure that every hussar here does as many much damage as possible, so that they don't run into each other, but they will all trying to give them, try to give them a different unit. And that means that I will increase my total damage output here. I keep doing that. I keep giving them a different target, and that's just what you should do. Also, by the way, if you have, I also made a previous tutorial which was about playing cavalry, mainly in team games. There's also some more details about how you can micro your cavalry and what you should do, how you should play it and stuff like that. Just check it out on my YouTube or Twitch. I think it's really instructional. Then the next one. Let's see what I got here. Strelet stagger mode. Oh yeah, that's a quite It depends on how fast you are with your mouse and how much is going on at the same time. But basically, if you have a group of a lot of infantry units, especially skirmisher strats like this, and you face cavalry, you don't want to stay at one point, because he can then micro his cavalry, like I showed you 5 seconds ago, and give them all different targets. So what he will do is target this strat with this Uhlan, this Uhlan goes on this strat, this one on this one, etc. Thus increasing his total damage output, and that just sucks for you. You have two options here. You keep them in normal mode, that's this one here. Try to make the best out of it. Shoot one cavalry, move back, shoot the same cavalry again, so you take out one as fast as possible. Don't use attack move here, because you want to take out one, because then their total damage will their total damage output will decrease. That's one thing. Another option here is to use stagger mode. That's this one. First of all, it's really useful, for example, when attacking into a fort or cannons, because what this will do is increase the space between your units. And that means that you will also receive less damage from cannons, because they're not as clumped up together. It will also slow them down a little bit. But what it also does, and that's very nice in my opinion in this case, it will, if you do it correctly, which is very hard by the way, it will fuck up the path of this army of his. The cavalry is gonna run into this, and if you keep microing your way back, his cavalry will keep moving. I did this mode like somewhere here, and you see that his cavalry will keep moving like in kind of in a vertical line. It's really hard for his cavalry to really get in a good position on your strelets or skirmishers or whatever you have, because they are so far out of each other. And that means that they, when you move back, they will all move in the same direction and they will bump into each other. Here you see that he now started to manually move his cavalry and manually target different strelets over here. And then I can keep going back here. And what you see, this is what I see, what I mean. This strelet was over here, moved to there. This cavalry is chasing it, and now you see that this one and this one are kind of also want to go into this direction, but they run into each other. And if you have all your units close together, it's sometimes it's easier for him to get a good surround, because he can just run two Uhlans to the back or to the side and avoid this problem. It's kind of a difficult situation here, because you can also do it with a normal mode, but it's just something I wanted to show you. It can be useful in some situations, but it needs a lot of micro. Putting this strelet towards here, putting this strelet towards there, and then manually micro the whole group back, pull this strelet over here, etc. It can really mess with the path of the cavalry, and thus decrease the total damage output of your opponent, and your units live longer. Well, I'm getting really slow here. Okay, where was I again? It's 4 a.m. It's almost done, by the way, guys. 1440. Okay, let's see what I have here. Positioning behavior close might more who could serve a small group. Okay, this is going to be another example about positioning and micro. Any moment, these Uhlans will come in and try to destroy me. But what is really going to happen here is I will come up ahead. And how you will do that? You are about to see. I have strelets mixed in here. I have, of course, weak Russian musketeers, so this is not a good thing for me. He has Uhlans, if I remember correctly. He also had cards for them, so they're really, really strong now. So what will you do here? First thing you saw me is moving back. You don't want to engage the fight over there. I will move back in a position that is best for me. I have ranged units, he has melee units. So first of all, move back, because you can't fight in the open field. Secondly, find a good position. Fighting near barracks or near your outpost is always good because it does extra damage on your enemy's cavalry. Third, find a good position to stay in, where you will receive as less damage as possible, but because you have ranged units, you can still do as much damage as possible. I even built a house here because it will mess up with the cavalry path even more. That's what I talked said before, using your buildings to your advantage. What you see here is that his cavalry has to go towards here, around here. Here is a small spot and they have to walk around this house. I will move my units here. Wait a second. Hold on. We're almost there. Go. I think that I'm just trying to catch him because I made some more Cossacks here. And of course use any shots I can get off with the musketeer before he really commits to a fight is good for me. And I can still move back because I'm close towards my my barracks. I wonder where I is. Yeah, it's about to happen here. I think I just was like, I will just get it with better micro, but then I thought like, okay, let's just back off because I'm not gonna get it. Too many Ulans here. Of course, look at this mess he has. So I'm still running back. I'm still running back here. I'm getting into the position I want to be. That means towards my barracks. Actually, to have this done the most optimal, I should have used my musketeers over here in the back, while all the Cossacks should be in front, like I wanted to do here, but then I just went on the map again. If you have your musketeers and all your ranged units over here and the Cossacks in front, your ranged units will do the most damage in the back while not dying because they are weak. The Cossacks will block off the Uhlans while still doing the damage, of course. So here you see that these Uhlans here in the back, they don't do anything. These attack, but they are not doing anything because of my house. These have to run around because of my blockhouse. And these have to run around because I stand close to this house again and have my Cossacks in front. So this is the position thing. Then here, I'm gonna use melee mode for a few musketeers here, like about 5 or 6. The other ones here, I won't use melee mode for. They will stay in the back, do good damage still. The reason why I use melee mode for these ones is that because they're in front and there are a lot of Uhlans here, so they will immediately do good melee damage and I will make sure that they will not do range damage. The melee damage is of course more, so if you can do melee damage is always good. If I would use melee mode for these musketeers as well, there will be too many units in melee mode and they will just run into each other and that's going to be not good. So I keep these one in ranged mode and I keep these one in melee mode. And what you will see here is that they will all find their target. Of course with some help from me here. You will see that these have a target here. These ones get their target. These ones get a target and these ones get a target. And the other ones here and here just stay in ranged mode. But because I know there was really going to be a fight here, then you can put your musketeers in melee mode and manually give them their own target. If you don't give them a target manually, they will run into each other and clump into each other, and then they're not efficient, of course, because they don't do any damage at all, and you might as well have let them in ranged mode. So if there's a real fight and you're really gonna commit, and he will as well, put some of the musketeers you have in front in melee mode and keep some in the back in ranged mode and manually readjust their targets for the ones that you have in melee mode. And if he's running away with cavalry, of course quickly change back to range mode so you can still get off a shot or two instead of only running after him with your melee mode musketeers. Okay, last one. Oh yeah, another example here of another micro trick. What you see here is that I don't want to engage this army because I just I don't have enough. I shouldn't have been there in the first place, but this is how it is. I'm here, and Ramax here has musketeers and hussars. The reason why it's often nice to mix in hussars here, for example, versus Russia, versus British, versus in the French mirror when you go musk-huss, you can always raid with them, very nice, but the main thing here, when I'm talking about micro, they can be used to slow down your enemy's army. And if you at some point know that you have the better army and you're gonna win, you want to make sure that he doesn't escape. And you can then use your hussars to attack his army. Of course, not all these hussars are gonna attack this musketeer, but you try to have these musketeers, these hussars attack this musketeer, this one attacks this one, etc. That as many musketeers are gonna be slowed down. What happens then is that my whole group is gonna be slowed down unless I manually micro this part of the group back and manually micro this part on the hussars, for example. So what you will see here is he will come in, do as I said here, and slow down my units. I already anticipated this, so I already moved a few musketeers back. You see here that this musketeer is occupying these four hussars, so actually that's a mistake of him. He should have moved his hussars. Like one is here is fine, but the other hussars should have moved over here. But he moved these hussars already over here, and these are now slowing down these musketeers, making it harder for me, as you see, to move back. Meanwhile, all the time, these infantry units of him, which are more than I have now, are attacking my units, and they can do more damage than normally because this group of me is being slowed down, and that means that I just can't run away. He's probably using attack move here, which is perfectly fine. That means that he will, in two shots or so, kill off this front row every time that I walk away. You're probably not able to do it that efficiently with... What he could do is select 1, 2, 3, 4 small groups and kill off these musketeers, but he has to micro a lot with his hussars as well and give them different targets. That just moving attack move is more important. It's more important here to move close and to keep moving closer than to have the most efficient fire for your infantry. The main job here is to slow down my units so your attack move mass infantry army can kill as many units of me as possible. So attack move using attack move while moving closer, attack move again, move closer, attack move again, move closer, etc. Attack move, by the way, just a quick reminder, you can set a short key to that in your hotkey options and you can use it in these situations. You will use the short key set for it and then left click on the map towards where you want to use your attack move on. So in this case you will click, I think it's left mouse button, so right mouse button you will use to move towards me, then attack move short key, left click on these behind these musketeers here, use the attack move option, right click again to move closer, go for attack move, etc. That's what he's gonna do all the way. Meanwhile, hussars are still gonna track me here, keep slowing down my units. I have to now let more units behind, and now I'm finally free, so to say, for a little bit, because they are coming in again, and then I could move back. So that was a very good thing of how you can use your cavalry to slow down the other units, only of course if you know you're going to win that fight and you want to keep slowing him down to do as much damage as possible. Of course, this trick you can also use when you are defending, for example, with Minutemen and let's say a few hussars. For example, someone is attacking you with 10 musketeers and you have 3 hussars and a tower center fire. You can call out Minutemen, but then he can run. If you have your hero, which of course you now know all that you have your hero always with you when you fight, also if you defend at your town center, you will put your hero in melee mode. You will click on the musketeer, slow him down. You will slow down his group unless he lets one musketeer behind, but in most cases you will slow down the group. You will use your 3 hussars to also give them each a specific target of musketeers. You will slow them down as well. Meanwhile, in the back, your 8 crossbowmen shipment or your minutemen or whatever you have popping out that it's ranged, that is a ranged unit, will keep shooting at these musketeers, and they will all die because you did this amazing trick of slowing them down and he couldn't run away. Okay, then That is the last thing, spread attack plus move option. Let's see. Okay, yeah. Using attack move is efficient when you can, when you have so many units that you can't really micro better by doing it manually. Or when you, for example, want to go shoot back, shoot back, shoot run, going back versus some units with your bigger range, for example, like a skirmisher versus musketeers, as I explained before. Here, you want to use, I want to use attack move as well. Maybe it was because it was late, I don't know. Then it's of course easier as well. But in other cases, it's still a good option here. However, attack move means that every unit is going to attack the closest unit in range. So if I have these units positioned in the way I have them now, that means that these musketeers, this one and this one and this one, is going to be the closest one for all these units. And that means I don't need so many units to kill three musketeers. So I'm probably wasting fire. So what you want to do then, it's actually a very important thing that I'm doing at the last, last scenes of my tutorial here. You want to reposition your army in a way that it is most effective and does the most damage. So what you see here is I'm selecting this small group here and move it towards here. I will then select this small group, which is in the back, and move it towards here. What you will then get is like a typical arc, as they call it. You will have your units in the horizontal line as good as possible. And that will mean that your attack move is more efficient, because they will all have more different units to attack. And they will not all have just one or three, one or two musketeers in front that they will attack and waste fire. They will all have, let's see how this turns out. They will, you see here that I'm making this arc here manually. They will all have now more different targets to attack, and that will mean that my total output damage will be better because my waste fire will be less. Here I'm gonna go back because there were just too many units at that point, and his cuirassier were dead, and cannons. Here, of course, you have range still, use your range, pick off a goon, and go back again. Okay. Well, that's all I have for now. Of course, I can make many more examples, I can gather many more examples, but I think it's already a 2-hour tutorial, so that's a lot of learning, a lot of stuff for you to learn and to think about. What I try to do here is show some basic unit things, like counter units, as I explained, skirmisher versus musketeer, stuff like that. Also, I talked about positioning, deciding which unit is the most annoying, which is the biggest damage dealer to take out at first, some cost effectiveness, which unit you want to take out first and how you want to use your units in battle, and what you want to sometimes you want to use your hussars to slow down musketeers, like I showed before. Well, of course, it's not cost effective to fight musketeers, but in the end it can be beneficial in some situations because you can get more advantages, like having your whole infantry must kill off more musketeers than your hussars lost in HP. So that's gonna be it for now. More tutorials will follow later on. I hope you enjoy it, and come back later.